वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व लीट कोड प्रॉब्लम 78 सबसेट्स। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट लुकिंग द डिटेल्स अबाउट द प्रॉब्लम एंड इट्स सॉल्यूशन एंड इम्प्लीमेंटेशन, आई वांट टू मेंशन दैट आई ऑफन क्रिएट यू नो जावा J2E इंटरव्यू स्पेसिफिक वीडियोज एंड कोडिंग वीडियोज, लीट कोड सॉल्यूशन वीडियोज। So if you are someone like who wants to learn Java or preparing for Java interviews, please subscribe to the channel. It has a lot of good playlist, check it out. So please subscribe to the channel. So let's look at this problem now. So given an integer array nums of unique elements, return all possible subsets, the power set. The solution set must not contain duplicate subsets. Return the solution in any order. So they have given us these examples. So 1, 2, 3, and as you can see, these are the generated subsets. So we can actually go and we can look at the same example over here. So we are going to use a recursion and we are going to generate the subsets recursively. So for the solution, what we are going to do is we are going to start with an empty list, right? With an empty list we will start, and then we will gradually, like, we will loop in this 1, 2, 3, and then we will keep adding the element and then again recursively calling the function. So how the recursive function will work is, in the beginning we have an empty list, then we are at 1. So we will actually go and we will add 1 into our list. So our list becomes like this, it is 1, and then we are actually calling the same recursive function, and we will have like now 2 and 3 that we will recursively add into this 1, right? So after this 1 is added, for next time it will have 1, we will pass this 1 to the function and it will add 1 and 2, like, right? So 2 will be added into that, and after 2 is done, the next time only 3 is remaining, so this one will go and it will add 3 into this 1 and 2, right? So it will become 1, 2, 3. So like this it will be printing the subset, and after this one is reaching at this point 3, then it will backtrack, right? So at the time of backtracking we are going to remove this 3, right? Because whatever we added we will remove, so we will go from here to here, and here like 1, 2 is already there. So now here again we will backtrack from here, we have added 2 here, right, in 1. So we will go back here. Now at this time we can add 1 and 3 here, right? Because 3 will be added at this time, because recursively the call will go back in the backtracking way. And here the already when we were looking at 1, 2 is added here in this way, and then remaining 3 will be added here, so it will become 1, 3. So it will print the 1, 3, and after this one is done it will remove the 3, right, when it is going to backtrack. So it will remove the 3 and then it will backtrack here with 1 added. Now again it will backtrack from 1 towards this one actually, which is the initial empty list, right? And now means we are done with 1, right? We are done with this index in the recursive function. Now we will add this one into our empty list basically. So we are in like this is the index 0, so we are done with index 0. Now we are looking at index 1 in the recursive function. So it will add 2 into this empty list here, and next time it will look at 3 and it will add 3 into this list after that, right? So 2 will be passed, and next one it will look at 3. 3 is the next index, right? So it will look at 3 and it will add 3 into this list. So it will print both this, and again it will backtrack, right? Because after 3 there is nothing, so it is done. So it will backtrack from 2, 3 to 2. So at this time it will remove what it has added, right, 3. Now again it will backtrack from 2 to the original one, so it will remove what it added at this time, right? Because it is a recursive call and we are using backtracking. So at this time we are done with 2. Now we will be at the index 2 here, means we are done with index 1 and now we are going to visit index 2. So at the index 2 we will now again empty list and we will add 3 here, right? So and whenever we are getting any of this list, we are capturing that in our result list. So at this time after 3 there is nothing, so it will remove it, it will backtrack to the original list and again it will backtrack from the original list the function. So this is how we are going to print all the subsets. So let me show you the code. So basically we created a list of integers because that is what we are going to return here from the subsets function. And we have implemented a function called as generate subsets. So generate subsets does not return anything. It will like what we are going to pass the result here, and then we are going to pass an empty list in the beginning, right? That's why we are passing a new linked list of integers. And we keep adding the, so first we will add that this empty list here, and then we are going to do for loop, and we will do for loop for 1, 2, and 3. So that's what I was showing you. So this first thing is when we are doing so this first thing that I explained here, this whole thing, this is when we are doing the for loop for 0, right? Means 1. Then this one is when we are doing in the for loop when we are at the index 1. And this last one, 3, is we are at the index 2. So that's what will happen. So we are, the start is 0 in the beginning, and whenever we like first we will add that number into our list, whatever list we have at that time, and we will again call generate subsets recursively. But at this time we will increment the start is equal to start plus 1. I plus 1 means first it is 0, then now it is becoming it will become 1, and then it will become 2. So it will go until the whole array, right? Nums.length. And we are passing the array here, then we are passing the result here, and we are passing the list that we have. So whenever we are adding into the result, you know, next time again, then we always use a new linked list and we pass this list there, right? Otherwise it will append it to the original list. And after our recursive call is done, we always remove the last one that we added, right? As I was showing you here. So after this one is done, we will remove the last one that we added, which is 3, right? Then we go back here. Again, we will remove what last one we added to. Again, we go back here in 1. Then we add the new one, 3. And again, once we are done with 1, 3, we will again remove 3. And we will come back here. So that's how the backtracking works. So this list.remove and we will remove list.size minus 1 means the last element that we added, we are removing it. It is backtracking. So so this is how the implementation is, and at the end we will just return the result. So let's just take the examples that's given to us, and we can just make sure that it's generating correct subsets. So as you can see, the subsets are getting correctly generated. So it is like, you know, if there are 3 numbers, then it will be 2 raised to 3, means total 8 elements will be there in the subset. Here total 2 raised to 1 means total 2 elements will be there, right? So similarly, if you want to just quickly loop, you can just say 1, 2. So now 4 elements will be there in the generated subset. So as you can see here, 4 elements came, this one, then blank 1, and then 1, then 1, 2, and 2. So it is like that's how the power set works. So this is how we can solve the subsets problem by using recursion. So let me just submit the solution and make sure it is accepted. So our solution is getting accepted with 61% and 1 MS, which is pretty decent. So as I said in the beginning, I often create lead code videos and solutions in Java J2E, as well as I create Java J2E helpful interview videos for junior and mid-level developers, and also have some informative videos for like how to answer questions in Java interview. So please subscribe to the channel. You will get a lot of good material on this channel. Thanks for watching.